सुष्ठुभां सस्तनुभिर्व्यसीम देवहितं यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धस्रवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नोतार्क्षो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु। ॐ शांति शांति शांतिः। तदेतत् सत्यं मन्त्रेषु कर्माणि कवयो यान्यपश्यन् स्तानि त्रेतायां बहुधा सन्ततानि तान्याचरथ नियतं सत्यकामा ईशवः पन्थाः सुकृतस्य लोके। यदा लीलायत हर्ची समिद्धि हव्यवाहनी तदाद्यभागावन्तरेणाहुति प्रतिपादयितुम् जस्याग्निहोत्रमदर्शमपूर्णमास मचातुर्मास्यमना ग्रयणमतिथि वा वर्जितं च अहुतम वैश्वदेवमभिधिना हुतमा सप्तमांस्तस्य लोकान् हिनस्ति। काली कराली च मनोजवा च शूलोहिताया च सुधूम्रवर्णाम् स्फुलिङ्गिनी विश्वरुची च देवी लीलायमाना अतिसप्तजुहाः। एते सुजश्चरते व्राजमाने सुजता कालम् चाहुतयो ह्याददायन् तं नयन्ति ताः सूर्यस्य रश्मयो यत्र देवानां पतिरेको दिवासः। एहो हीति तमाहुतयः सुवर्चसः सूर्यस्य रश्मीभिर्यजमानं वहन्ति प्रियाहं वाचमभिवदन्त्योर्चयन्त्य एषवः पुण्यः सुकृतो ब्रह्मलोकः। प्लवायिते अदृढा यज्ञरूपा अष्टादशोक्तमवरं येषु कर्म एतत्रेयो येऽभिनन्दन्ति मूढा जरा मृत्युं ते पुनरेवापि यन्ति। अविद्यायामन्तरे वर्तमानाः स्वयं धीराः पण्डितं मन्यमानाः जङ्घन्यमानाः पर्यन्ति मूढा अन्धेनैव नीयमाना यथान्धः। अविद्यायां बहुधा वर्तमाना वयं कृतार्था इत्यभिमन्यन्ति बालाः यत्कर्मिणो न प्रवेदयन्ति रागातेनातुराः क्षीणलोकाश्चवन्ति। ईस्तापूर्तं मन्यमाना वरिष्ठं नान्यत् श्रेयो वेदयन्ति प्रमूढाः न कस्य पृष्ठे ते सुकृतेऽनुभूत्वे मङ्गलोकं हीनतरं वा विशन्ति। तपः श्रद्धेये ह्युपवसन्त्यरन्ये शान्ता विद्वांसो भैक्षचर्यां चरन्तः सूर्यद्वारेण ते विरजाः प्रयान्ति यन्नामृतः स पुरुषो हव्ययात्माम् परीक्ष लोकान् कर्म चित्तान् ब्राह्मणो निर्वेद मायात् नास्त्य कृतः कृतेन तद्विज्ञानार्थं स गुरुमेवाविगच्छेत् समित्पाणिः श्रोत्रियं ब्रह्मनिष्ठम् तस्मै स विद्वानुपसन्नाय सम्यक् प्रशान्तचित्ताय समन्विताय येनाक्षरं पुरुषं वेद सत्यं प्रोवाचतां तत्त्वतो ब्रह्म विद्या। ॐ शांति शांति शांतिः।
Now, reference is made to the Agnihotra, which is the first of all sacrifices. When the flame moves after the fire is well fed by fuel, one should offer the oblation in the place called Abhapasthana. At the Agnihotra, two portions of Ajya, that is ghee, are sacrificed. And the right and the left side of the Avahaniya altar with the
invocations
like Agnaya Swaha and Somaya Swaha. The place between the two is called the Avapasthana, and here the oblations to the gods are to be offered. This is the road to the attainment of good worlds. But it is not easy to perform Agnihotra in the proper manner, as there are many impediments. Flame is the tongue of the fire. Therefore, all oblations are offered into the very mouth of Agni, the god of fire. He who performs Agnihotra should necessarily perform Darsha, Purnamasa, Chaturmasya, Agrayana and Vaishyadeva rituals. He should propitiate guests daily. When the karma is properly performed, the seven worlds beginning with Bhuhu and ending with Satya are obtained as a result, according to the fruition of karma. By irregular performance of the Agnihotra, one cannot attain any of the seven worlds, that is Bhur, Bhuva, Swa, Maha, Jana, Tapa, and Satyalokas. They are therefore said to be, as it were, destroyed. Irregular performance of the Agnihotra destroys one's future in the seven worlds. It may mean that the three ancestors, that is the father, the grandfather, and the great-grandfather, and the three descendants, namely the son, the grandson, and the great grandson, who are connected by the offer of oblations, do not confer any benefit on him on account of the irregular performance of the sacrifice. The seven worlds may also be the worlds of the father, grandfather, and great grandfather, of the son, the grandson, and the great grandson, and of the sacrificer himself. The seven flickering tongues of the fire are Kali, that is black one, Karali, the terrific one, Manojava, that is swift as the mind, Shulohita, the deep red, Sudhumravarna, the smoke colored, then Sphulingini, sparkling, and the Vishwarupi are Vishwaruchi, having all forms. The Agnihotra is to be performed only in a well-lit fire, not in a fire which is smoking. The seven flames are the seven tongues of the fire. The seven tongues of the flaming fire, from Kali down to Vishwaruchi or Vishwarupi, are intended to swallow the oblations thrown unto it. Whoever performs his karma, that is Agnihotra, when these flames are shining and in proper time, then these oblations lead him through the rays of the sun to wherever the one Lord of the Devas dwells. Come hither, the brilliant oblations say unto him, and carry the sacrificer through the rays of the sun, addressing to him the pleasant words of praise. This is the holy world of Brahma, heaven, gained by the good works. How these oblations carry the performer of the sacrifice along the solar rays is now explained. They say, "Welcome, welcome." These oblations greet him with sweet words, words of praise and propitiating. They address him with such pleasing words as, "This is thy holy world of Brahma, gained by the good works." The word Brahmaloka means Swarga or heaven by the force of the context. Perishable and transient are verily the 18 supporters of the sacrifice on whom this lower ceremonial depends. Those ignorant persons who delight in this as the highest good are subject again and again to old age and death. In the beginning, the Upanishad eulogized the sacrifices as they help a man in attaining heavenly enjoyments, and then developing disgust for these enjoyments as they are ephemeral. Now it clearly points out that they cannot help him a bit in the attainment of the final emancipation. The ignorant beings, in the midst of ignorance, but fancying themselves wise and learned, go round and round, oppressed and miserable, as blind people led by the blind. Steeped in ignorance, yet thinking in their own minds, "We alone are intelligent and have known all that should be known." Fools wonder about flattering themselves, much afflicted by old age, sickness, and lot of other troubles, over and over again, as the blind people in this world, walking in the pain, pointed out by the other equally blind people, fall into the ditches and pits. Living in various ways in ignorance, the ignorant imagine that they have obtained their end, because the performers of work are not wise. Owing to their patience, they become miserable, and after the fruits of their karma are finished, fall from heaven. The ignorant act in a variety of ways in ignorance. They foolishly think that they have attained the end of life. They flatter themselves that they have attained what they sought. They consider themselves happy. They have no foresight or wisdom. On account of their attachment to rewards, they do not learn the truth, as they always long for the fruits of karma. They fall and become miserable when their life in this world, which they had gained by their good works, is finished. When their merits are exhausted, they fall miserably back into rebirth. They fall from heaven after the fruits of their karma are exhausted. One can attain the final liberation or the immortal state only by attaining the knowledge of Brahman. Knowledge can only dawn when man annihilates desires and attachment. Life in heaven is also impermanent. When the merits of one's deeds are exhausted, he is reborn on earth again. These ignorant persons, fancying sacrifice and charitable gifts as their highest object, do not know any higher good, having enjoyed the fruits of their works on the high place of heaven, which they gain by their good works. They enter again this world or the lower one. But those who practice penance and faith in the forest with subdued senses, learned, and living the life of a mendicant, go freed from sin through the sun to where the immortal and imperishable Purusha dwells. Those who worship Saguna Brahman, personal God, attain gradual emancipation. They go to Satyaloka, they attain knowledge in Satyaloka, and are finally emancipated at the end of the cycle. Along with Brahma, they merge in the Nirguna Brahman, the impersonal absolute, at the end of the cycle. But sages, Jivan Muktas, who have attained knowledge of the self, attain Kaivalya Mukti. They do not go to any world. Their prana, etc., are directly absorbed in Brahman. They become one with the Supreme Self. They attain liberation in this very life. Let a Brahmana, that means an aspirant, after he has examined the worlds gained by karma, acquire freedom from all desires, reflecting that nothing that is eternal can be gained by karma. Let him, in order to obtain the knowledge of the eternal, take sacrificial fuel in his hands and approach that preceptor alone who is versed in the Vedas and is established in Brahman. Having duly approached the Guru with fuel in hand as a sign of discipleship, let the aspirant propitiate him and question him about the true and immortal Brahman. To that pupil who has approached him respectfully, whose mind is at rest and whose senses are subdued, let the wise teacher truly teach that Brahmavidya, the science of Brahman, through which the true immortal Purusha is known. It is the duty of the preceptor to remove all doubts of the disciple, to teach him the hidden meaning of the Vedas and to help him in all possible ways to cross the ocean of ignorance and attain the knowledge of Brahman. Hari Om Tat Sat.